So this literally minutes shirt, unfortunately my thread ran out, so I had to take a little bit of a pause. Now I've put the piping on, and what I'm going to do is change the foot back and continue with completing this in literally minutes of. The whole thing is just going to literally take minutes. So it's not, we're going to try and keep it as simplified as possible. Now what we're going to do is complete the neck, and I've just actually literally just ironed on some interfacing in a square neckline, which I conveniently just went and got lost as well. Overlocked. And just put it to a side, and I think it's blown away somewhere. I think I'm gonna have to turn this fan off because no fun working with the fan on because it keeps blowing everything away. Oh, there they are. They're blown under the machine. Okay, so just, oh, doesn't want to stay at all. It's very difficult working with the fan blowing everything away. So, now then, one of the things that I experienced with Naya was that she absolutely loathes deep cut back neck. I actually recently did an outfit for her, and I didn't want to put buttons on it, and I made the neckline wide, which she actually was constantly tugging and pulling at it because she was finding it uncomfortable. So it might be an idea to actually not make the children's necklines too wide. Okay, so put this up, notch to the corner of both the necklines. Tug on it slightly, turn over the corners, and we're just going to finish this off by actually just stitching. What we're going to do is just finish this off with stitching this, because I don't want to be messing around with. I have overlocked this, so to put down the work time. Now with lawn and cottons, there is the beauty of sewing this very, very easily. Now we're going to leave a slight bit of an opening. We're going to leave a slight bit of an opening at the top and a slight bit of an opening at the bottom, because we want to give this like a shirt-like effect. But on the seam that I've done on the inside, I'm just going to close it off probably about just past the waist mark. It's going to be like a part open shirt. Now if this design comes out nice, then what I will do is replicate this for Halima as well. Now unfortunately, as you can see, the pieces were on that side of an angle, so I had to leave the opening on the opposite side. Generally we leave it on the left side. This particular one, I've had to leave it on the right side. So place your lining, back of the dress underneath, and place the blowing everything away. Okay, so place the two pieces together. And we're just gonna close this off. Now I just need a very small piece to trim the back of the dress off in a bias. We're gonna do this in one go, so. I hope this inspires many of you to actually go ahead and make stuff like this. I know a lot of people are very reluctant to actually sew for children. They say that you can buy so easily, there's so much available. Yes, it's true. But you know what, if you make the children's, it will prepare you for making your own, because you will pick up tips and skills that will be beneficial for yourself in making these. Plus, I think my personal view is that it builds a bond between and children when parents, when mothers make the garments for their children. I had one lady machinist in the shop yesterday, and she says to me, "Oh, I don't have time for making clothes for my daughter." And I was not happy listening to that, because I think if there is anyone that you should be making time for, is your own children. If you haven't got time for your own children, then that's saying that you're giving precedence to your or other people over your own children. I know my mom often says to me that in the time that you sew for Inaya, you could have, you know, you have so much workload, you could have so much else done. And yes, it's true, but I always say to her that, "Mom, the time I give to Inaya is the time that I would generally give to myself. And if I'm giving that time to myself, then I don't mind investing it in my, you know, if I'm going to sit around watching TV, I would rather spend that time making something for Inaya than sitting there watching TV, because that's time wasted and this is time well spent." What we're going to do is we're just going to close this off. I was initially going to make this into an open chemise, but a closed chemise is a lot easier. So what we're going to do is just close it off and overlock it and lace it at the bottom. And we can add very simple lace, which I've managed to locate in same colours. Okay, so that's all the threads and stuff trimmed away. We are just going to add the final touch of finishing this off with the lace. The lace that I'm going to use is this one. And it's going to be a very, very simple attachment of the lace. Now the whole process of making this tube has taken me, half an hour. So if you plan well, it can actually even take you less. I went with a spare of the moment and I didn't actually plan 100%. But if you plan well, then I tell you that you can actually get away with making this outfit in less time. So join me again for Inaya modeling this outfit. I hope you enjoy and like what I've created. I hope you all go on to make similar ones because the whole process of making this is so simple. Now it's just actually this little bit of the fabric is actually just showing, so I just wanted to hem that in, trim away the threads, press, and maybe add a couple of buttons to go at the front of it in a turquoise color, and you're firing.